Robin D. Laws for Pelgrane Video. So the question before us today is, what is our favorite monster? And this individual's favorite monster is the giant centipede. A lot of my colleagues have picked cool monsters who have personalities you can interact with. They have cultures. Some people kind of want to be those monsters. But sometimes you just need an impersonal threat, and a particularly nasty monster that you always want to fight because it's horrible, and you're not going to feel bad because, you know, that you're not going to regret that the giant centipede has nieces and nephews or has an important contribution to the musicology of its culture, or, you know, maybe is responsible for running a restaurant. You don't have to worry about any of that stuff. I also have to say that I like the giant centipede due to the role the centipede plays in the works of one of my favorite authors, William S. Burroughs. In the case of Burroughs, there's a suggestion sometimes that you can chop up the giant centipede and snort him, and he has hallucinogenic effects. So that also creates an interesting thing, you know, because sometimes monsters are treasure. It might be interesting to do sort of an F20 game where people are fighting centipedes and then converting them into a banned substance, which they then try to get past the man. You can have sort of a almost sort of a biker style a Narcos D&D game. Some might say you should go for a monster with like a bigger fantasy footprint or credibility, like the giant spider. But first of all, giant spiders in Tolkien, they have personalities like Shelob, and I don't want a personality for these things that were that I want to have come out of the woodwork to have to fight you at any time. Also, spiders, they're very respectable. You know, they build things, they care for their webs, they hunt the annoying bugs that live in your house. Some of them will point out the virtues of exemplary pigs, for example. Centipedes never do anything like that. And then once they crawl into your house, they're super awful and scuttly, and I want to have someone to deal with them. And that brings us to the next quality of a giant centipede, is its versatility. What can you put a giant centipede in? Can you put it in a regular horror game? Yes, you can. How about a techno thriller horror? Yes, centipedes, you can fight them in that. What about reality horror? Vampire horror? Is centipedes just for horror? No, they're, as previously mentioned, they could be a fantasy creature. Or how about space opera? You can put a centipede in a space opera. Or even, let's say, Meet in City Blues. There's no giant centipedes in that, but you could have a vigilante called the giant centipede, or probably just a centipede, and you could have your characters fight him. So, the centipede is just a miles long of creepy, and you can fit it in pretty much anything. And I think there's a centipede around here now, so I got to go fight it. But this has been Robin D. Laws for Pelgrane Video.